I'm just going to come out and say it. MAC addresses don't get the appreciation they deserve. They often get overshadowed by IP addresses, and especially when it comes to home networks, I would argue that MAC addresses are more important. As a result, that's what we're going to change today. We're going to put some respect on MAC addresses' name. We're going to be talking about what MAC addresses are, how they work, and how you can find out what the MAC addresses of your devices are. So what is a MAC address? Well, first off, MAC stands for Media Access Control, and I'll be the first to admit that that doesn't really do a good job of describing what a MAC address actually is. To put it simply, a MAC address is basically just like a name tag or an identifier for all the physical devices in your home network. This hardware gets assigned a MAC address when the device is physically created, and this MAC address is something that doesn't change. It's a unique identifier for that piece of hardware for its entire life. All of the devices in your home network will have MAC addresses, and in some cases, they'll have more than one. So what are these situations? Well, if your device connects to the internet in multiple different ways, for example, if it can connect to the internet over Wi-Fi or over an Ethernet cable with a wired connection, it will have two different MAC addresses. What happens is each network interface card on the device will get assigned a unique MAC address, and you will have a network interface card for the wireless connection to the internet and a network interface card for the Ethernet connection to the internet. So what does a MAC address look like? Well, here's an example. In computer speak, it's a 48-bit number, but basically what it looks like is it is 12 total characters. It can be numbers and letters, and it's broken up into six pairs. And this is in hexadecimal notation. So basically what this means is you can convert each of these pairs into a given number. That's probably more information than you need to know, but what is important to know is that your MAC address is basically broken up into two different identifiers. The first three pairs of characters, they will identify the manufacturer of the device. So for example, if you have a TP-Link device, TP-Link has been assigned a range of available IDs that they can use for their devices. So that's what these three pairs of numbers and letters identify. So if you have a TP-Link device, this number here, or these pairs of numbers, will fall into the range that's been assigned for TP-Link to use. The second pair of six characters here, this uniquely identifies the device itself. So if you have a router, for example, or you have a laptop, that laptop will be given a unique identifier that no other device has, and that will be encoded in the MAC address. So to tie it all together, a MAC address is a unique identifier for every device. No two devices will have the same exact MAC address. So why are MAC addresses important? Well, this is where the discrepancy where IP addresses get all the recognition here, but actually in the background, MAC addresses are doing a lot of the work. So, in your home network, each device will have a MAC address, and that's how devices know where to send data. If you have two devices on your home network that want to communicate with each other, they effectively use that MAC address in order to send that data to the right device. What you'll see in this example here is that IP addresses for devices can change, MAC addresses do not. So this permanent identifier for these devices, this is ultimately what's being used for devices to identify each other. Okay, so here we have an example of a home network. Let's start very simple. Let's say you have a router in your home network and no devices are connected to your router yet. One thing you might notice here is this router ARP table. ARP stands for Address Resolution Protocol. And basically all it means is this is a table that ties MAC addresses for devices to their IP address. So for a lot of people, the IP address of their router is 192.168.0.1. And because there are no other devices in the home network yet, your router only has one entry in its address resolution protocol table. It has its own IP address, 192.168.0.1, mapped to its very own MAC address, which is 0A, 1A, 2A, 3B, 4B, 5B. and this is just an example. All right, so at this point, let's say we have a laptop join the home network. The laptop will have its own ARP table, and the only entry it has, because it hasn't communicated with any other devices on the home network yet, is its own. It has its own IP address and its own MAC address in the ARP table. So let's say this laptop wants to go and make a request to the public internet. In order to do so, it needs to send that request through the default gateway or the router in the home network. And it knows that the router is located at 192.168.0.1. But at this point, this laptop doesn't know the MAC address of your router, so it can't send the information yet. What will happen is your laptop will send out a request and it will say, anyone on the home network, does anyone know the MAC address that's tied to 192.168.0.1? Here, the router is the only other device on the home network, but the router in its ARP table has that MAC address tied to its own IP address. So that router can respond and say, at my IP address, here is the MAC address. So it returns it to the laptop, and at the same time it says, okay, what is the MAC address of 192.168.0.2? I'd like to send this information back to this device. I need the MAC address of the device to do that. So basically what happens, this information is returned from the laptop to the router because the laptop knows the MAC address that's tied to 192.168.0.2. And then both of these devices can update their ARP tables. Here, your laptop has updated it. Your router now has this update from your laptop. So they both update their address resolution protocol tables. So they have a mapping of MAC addresses to IP addresses on the home network. At this point, let's say the laptop disconnects from the home network and then it later rejoins and gets a different IP address. Well, here we follow the same process, but what happens is this ARP table for the laptop gets updated with the router's information, and then the router updates its ARP table with the new IP address of the device and ties it to that same MAC address that this laptop always has. So the point I'm trying to show here is that MAC addresses don't change even though IP addresses do. So if you have a device disconnect from your home network, reconnect later with a different IP address, your devices will still figure out with this address resolution protocol mapping where to send the data and making sure to send the data to the correct devices. And this highlights the importance of MAC addresses, because if you were only using IP addresses to allow devices to communicate on your home network, every time a device disconnected from your home network and then maybe a different device connects and gets that previous IP address that was used by this laptop, this router would be sending data to the wrong device. In short, what MAC addresses do is they ensure data gets to the right device, regardless of the IP address that's assigned to that given device. These ARP tables will update as these devices change and changes are made to the home network, and it all works seamlessly in the background without you having to do anything. So as you can imagine, we can add additional devices to our home network here. Let's say we add a desktop, and the desktop hasn't communicated with any devices on the home network yet, so it only has one entry in its ARP table. But what happens is these devices all communicate with each other. They ask each other what MAC address is tied to this given IP address, and what you soon have is all devices on the home network will have their own updated ARP table with MAC addresses that are tied to each IP address that's being used. So hopefully now you realize that especially when it comes to your home network, IP addresses aren't the reason why data gets to the right devices. It's really the MAC addresses that are at play here. So if MAC addresses work in the background, when are the cases that you actually need to know the MAC addresses of your devices? Well, the most common use case is when you're activating your internet plan. What you need to do is you need to register your modem with your internet service provider. So basically what happens is you purchase an internet plan with your ISP. You then have to go and basically tell your ISP, hey, this is the modem that's tied to my internet plan that I'm paying monthly for. In order to register and have that account linked to your device, you need to give that identifier of your modem, which is its MAC address. Additionally, if you're on a university or a public Wi-Fi, you usually have to register your devices in order to use that internet connection. So if you have an Xbox, for example, you need to find out the MAC address of that Xbox. You need to identify it or register it with your university, and then you'll be able to use the internet. I should also mention that in a lot of router settings, what you can do is you can name devices based upon their MAC address. And this is good security practice because if you know the MAC address for all the devices in your home network, you name all your devices so you can easily recognize them. It makes it stand out whenever you have a device that you don't want on your home network. Whether it's a malicious device or a new device that you're connecting to your home network, it will stand out to you because it won't have a name that you've assigned for that device and for that MAC address. So where can you find the MAC address of your devices? Well, for most devices like a modem router combination device, or even a router, an Xbox, there'll be an informational sticker on the device itself, which details what that MAC address is. By now, you should be able to recognize a MAC address as we went through that example earlier. Here's another example on the bottom of this router. You might not be able to see it very well, but it shows the MAC address on there. You might just have to take my word for it. But if your device doesn't have an informational sticker, you should be able to go into the network settings and it will list the MAC address for that device. If you're having trouble finding out the MAC address of a device, or if there's a device where you'd like me to give a step-by-step procedure on how to determine what its MAC address is, please leave it in the comments and I'll see if I can make a video to help you out. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network From Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.